Hi, I'm Haja Dalwal, and this is Tackling Tech. Today, we continue the Windows 365 anniversary celebration by sitting down with Dave Rodriguez from Microsoft Digital, the team that powers, protects, transforms the employee experience across devices, applications, infrastructure within Microsoft. The goal? To hear how Microsoft is utilizing Windows 365 to deliver a familiar Windows experience from cloud to people everywhere on any device. Thank you for joining us today. Before we dive into the specifics of deploying Windows 365 cloud PCs within Microsoft, can you tell us a little bit more about Microsoft Digital and your role within that team?
Thanks, Harjit. I appreciate being here today and telling our story. So my role is a principal product manager in Microsoft Digital, and I look to lead the internal strategy on how we can use Windows 365 Cloud PC to better enable our employees for their productivity and their different aspects of their work. Microsoft Digital, you can think about as the evolution of what was the Microsoft IT, MSIT, to where we are now, where we are a first-party partner with the product groups, bringing our enterprise experience to evolve and transform these products for our enterprise needs and our customers' needs. We also power and secure all the aspects of our organization that requires digital technology to work.
So is it fair to say that you support Microsoft as customer zero when it comes to new products and services?
Yeah. So a principle of our customer zero perspective is that we are the first enterprise customer, right? We utilize the products and take our short feedback loop that we have with the product groups to enhance and evolve it from our experience at an enterprise customer to the benefits of all enterprises around the world.
So when did Microsoft Digital first start planning for Windows 65 Cloud PCs at Microsoft, and what was the process like?
Yeah, we've been on this journey of Windows 365 Cloud PC as long as the product. The Windows 365 product group, as it is now, has come to Microsoft Digital on early days to really learn from Customer Zero Enterprise what would a SaaS offering, a desktop as a service SaaS offering, look like in an enterprise, and what would the enterprise needs be. So we've been on this journey for as long as the Windows 365 product group for it.
Okay, so how did you decide which employees were good candidates for Windows 365? And did you do Windows Enterprise, or is it frontline?
Great, thanks for asking that. We have looked at our enterprise and to look at where we can apply Windows 365 in various segments. It's not necessarily what groups of users, but what scenarios is best fitted for Windows 365 Cloud PC. One of those that we found an excellent fit for is our repair loaners, where someone needs to go and get their physical device for a repair. We can offer them a Windows 365 Cloud PC to keep them productive while their physical device is out for repair and, you know, having it shipped back to them.
All right. What about Windows 365 GPUs? Are there any out there?
You know what? Windows 365 GPU is a very fascinating new area. We are exploring to understand where we might find a good fit for it, and we're continuing evaluating, is it right for our desktop as a service strategy?
Okay. So all Cloud PCs, Microsoft Entra ID joined, or are they in a hybrid situation?
Yes, all our Cloud PCs here are Entra ID joined. We are taking the cloud native first approach and managing our Windows 365 Cloud PCs as we manage the rest of our desktop. As part of our desktop as a service strategy, we think they're more or less the same. They're just your Windows 11 in the cloud instead of physically sitting in your hands.
In my interview with Aiden Marcus, he talked about the benefits of Windows 365 Cloud PCs. What are the benefits that you are seeing?
We're seeing benefits across the board. As we have polled our internal users who are utilizing it, we have an overabundance of feedback that Windows 365 is making them more productive in their day-to-day activities. Anecdotally, the feedback that we're getting, users are saying that they are roughly 56% more productive by utilizing Windows 365 across their physical device, their cloud, and being able to flex across all their different environments, home, work, tablet, etc. Where it's also very interesting for them is the ability to utilize the different form factors that they may have handy. One specific form factor I really personally love is the Motorola Think phone and the enhanced Windows 365 app. What I love about this is I can carry my phone with me where I'm at, and I have my personal compute on this. I can just stick it right into a cradle, and popping right up on the screen is a full-fledged Windows 365 Cloud PC that I use every day. And so I can just pop this back on, jump on the shuttle, the connector, and get back home without carrying a laptop with me.
That is amazing. So awesome.
It is.
How is offering cloud native experiences like Windows 365 Cloud PCs impacting the experiences of our employees at Microsoft?
So our employees at Microsoft, they have high expectations of us. They expect the best in class and transformative experiences. And providing a cloud native experience like Windows 365 Cloud PC allows us to meet them where they are. Some users will choose to use it. Some users may choose the physical desktop. What it does provide them is that showing that Microsoft, that employee-centric organization that we are meeting them where their needs are.
That's great. So let's dive into security. We know security is utmost important here at Microsoft. Zero trust needs to be applied everywhere. So how's Windows 365 Cloud PCs playing into what we do for security?
Yes, so true. What Windows 365 does, it really allows us to lean into the zero trust principles, right? And ensure that all our data resides on a Microsoft-owned, Microsoft managed Windows 11 cloud instance. Take example, our repair loaner, right? Usually someone has to get a physical machine. They have to log and set it up. Their personal information gets on it. Then they have to send it back. Ideally, hopefully, the person would wipe and reset it. Well, with Windows 365 boot, we are enabling these devices to be available for them in a locker, shipped to them, and all they have to do is log into their cloud PC, right? All the data stays on there. They can be productive while their main primary device is getting repaired, and they shut that thing down, put it back into the locker, or send it back, and no personal device data is on that physical machine for that person. So we don't have to worry about wiping it, restoring it, in itself. So it secures their data and actually makes it more productive for everyone involved in that process.
And it's also a great use case of Windows 365 Cloud PCs, right?
Exactly. And the Windows 365 boot features are really where we're looking to see how we can evolve our overall repair loaners and any sort of short-term need for personal desktops.
Okay, that's excellent. So before we wrap up, what tips do you have for IT departments, IT teams across the world who are starting their journey into, before they embark actually into Windows 365?
What I would say here is that Windows 365 Cloud PC can solve, it could apply to many different needs. And what I would suggest is looking at across your portfolio where there might be places where you're having some challenges in meeting a specific population need, and that Windows 365 Cloud PC, could it be an option for those? We found it as a great option for our repair loaner, and that was due to us surveying how we are utilizing desktops throughout our ecosystem.
Love it, Dave. Thanks for giving us a little peek behind the scenes of Microsoft Digital and what you do. If your organization is looking to adopt Windows 365, visit aka.ms/W365docs. That's aka.ms/W365docs to get started. Please like, subscribe, and comment on today's podcast, especially if there is a topic you'd like us to discuss and tackle in future episodes. I'll soon be on the road, so stay tuned for a new season of Tackling Tech later this year. Until then, thanks for listening.